Good afternoon. Welcome to Qi Gong with Randy Emerson. We're going to start off with throwing out the trash. Three more. All right, so now we're going to go to some trunk twisting. So I'm happy to still be able to do some online videos for the Munson Free Library on the Facebook page. But some great news, we are now outside at Veterans Field on Tuesday nights, 6 p.m. to 7 p.m., weather permitting. I'd like to see many of you out there. We have squares for social distancing. I believe the squares are a 10 by 10 square. So I hope you all can join me out there. Couple more. Now we're going to go to washing windows. So your front hand here, back hand's here, and you just sweep across the body. Switch hands. Nice warm weather out there the last few days. Probably people are going to the beach more often than going out for Qigong, but as the weather starts to cool down, hopefully we'll see you on Tuesday nights. Two more in this direction. Now we're gonna switch. This will be the trail hand. This will be the front hand. Still called washing the windows. Couple more. We're gonna switch the hands, wave like clouds. This will be the trail hand, this will be the front hand. Come across. Switch. two more. All right, so now we got lots of yin energy going, nice and calm. So now we're gonna ramp it up for some yang energy, and we're gonna do knee slapping. All right, a few more. Very good. That gets the heart rate up. Now we're gonna go into some meditative breathing. So your hands at your lower dantian. Breathing in and out through your nose, tongue to the roof of your mouth. Nice and relaxed. Three more. Now we're going to do opening Tai Chi move. So in this one here, you're going to bring your palms facing up, turn, push down. Three more. Now we're going to bring Qi to the palms. We're going to start off with our hands at the lower dantian. You're going to bring the hands up, push them out at the chest, over the head, This is a great exercise to do in the morning before work. Getting a good energy to flow. Three more. And this one here, we're gonna switch the exercise and do crossing hands. You swoop down, cross your hands, bring the energy up, uncross over your head. Two more. And this one here, we'll just rest our hands at the side. This next exercise is also called bringing Qi to the palms. You're gonna start with one hand in front of you. Your other hand comes across your chest. Then follows the arm down as the other hand comes back. You switch sides. Feel the energy as the hands pass. A couple more like this. Now we're going to switch. This hand's going to be up here. You're going to come down along the back side of the arm. And then switch. Two more. All right, so this one is similar to throwing out the trash. I'll just show you, we're gonna swing our arms up and back like this. We're gonna do that four times. And on the fifth one, we're gonna swing our arms back faster. This is another yawn exercise to build up the energy, build up the heart rate. Ready, begin. One more round. going to go back into some meditative breathing. And this one here will be connecting the body, mind, and spirit. So we're going to do 5 deep breaths at the lower dantian, expanding your hands out as you inhale and contracting your hands as you exhale. Slowly move your hands to the middle dantian. 5 deep breaths. Slowly move to the upper dantian. 5. Now we're going to do 1 at the upper dantian. And slowly move to the middle dantian. We'll do 1 there. And slowly to the lower dantian. Now we're going to go into the Wu stance, waiting for the blessings, also called. So your knees are slightly bent, toes are pointed forward, legs are shoulder width apart. Tongue to the roof of your mouth, breathing in and out through your nose. You imagine that your GV20 is connected to the heavens and your K1s, the bottom of your feet, are anchored firmly into the earth. Elbows slightly bent and the palms of your hand facing the floor. Three more deep breaths. Now we're going to do connecting the 5 elements. So your palms start behind you. You're going to exhale. Bring your hands to your lower dantian. Now you're going to inhale. Bring your hands up to your shoulders. Hold your breath. Push your hands down to the starting spot. And then exhale. This exercise is excellent for the immune system. It connects the elements, water, wood, fire, earth, and metal. We're going to do two more sets. Last one. Now you're going to take your fingers pointed together at the lower dantian. You're going to curl your fingers up, follow this line up. The hands push out flat and they connect, and you bring your hands back. Bring your palms back together. And then you follow the original line back to the starting point. One more round. All right, now you put your one hand on top of the other. Start off in the Wu stance. Bring one palm back down. Go to the middle of your back. Come out. Go out in front with the energy. Cross the body. And back down the front of the chest. Hand switch. more round on each side. Alright, so the hands will remain the same. We're going to go to a wider stance. This time it's serving the emperor's tea. So when your hand comes back from your back, it's going to be holding a teacup. So you want your palm facing up the entire time during this exercise. One more round on each side. This next exercise is going to be called holding the ball. You start with your palm here, and you just come across the body as you pivot, you rotate the hands, and come back across. This is a great meditative exercise, and you can feel the energy. Very relaxing. couple more. And on this one here, we're gonna stop in the middle. Switch the hands around. And one hand's gonna go to the heavens and one hand's gonna go to the earth. Connecting the energy. Last one. Now we're going to switch the two hands to the heavens. So your hands are here. You're going to turn sideways. Your hands come up. They push up. You hold. Slowly move to the center. Your hands come down in front. Do the other side. One more round on each side. Now you're gonna make a fist in the Wu stance. You start with your forearms together in front, then you stretch. You breathe in as your arms come back. And you exhale when your forearms come together. Two more. You're going to take your hands at your middle dantian, and you're going to do big circles with your upper body. We're going to go 9 in each direction. To 9, switch. Finish that. We're going to go into the 4 words, which are Zhen, Song, Jin, Kong. And you want to take a deep breath in with your hands over your head. You say the word, you extend the word all the way out to your hands, come back down to your sides. And then we're going to take a pause in between, a nice deep meditational breath before the next word. We'll start with the first one, Zhen. Song. So it is Jin. And calm. Now we're going to do grasping the wild sparrow's tail left and right. So you're going to start with holding the ball. You're going to step straight up. As your left hand comes up, your right hand goes back. Make sure your knee doesn't go any further than your toe. Then you grasp the sparrow's tail. Sit back. Put your palms together, push out. Come back. As you're coming back, your hands are going to go down to your waist. Then they're going to come back up, push out. And you're going to come across as you pivot with the back foot, holding the ball. Stepping back out. As now the right hand comes up, the left hand comes back. Grasp the sparrow's tail. Sit back. Palms go together. Push out. And back to the waist. Up. Push out. And then pivot. Now we're just going to flow. No thinking on this one, just let it go. This one does take some practice. It's amazing how everyone in the class, when we first started, were like, this one here is impossible to do. And now, they're all pros at it. They just pivot and swing and the arms go up and they don't even think about it. All right, we'll do one more round on each side. Now we're going to do some posing, and that exercise we just did is one of the poses. So see if you can see my foot back here. So it's at a slight angle, and then you're going to come out and hold this pose right here. Your weight should be heavy on the front foot and light on the back. Now we're going to switch to the other side. I'll come towards the camera this time. The poses build up very good strength, especially in the lower body. We only do them for like 30 to 45 seconds, but we should be doing these for 5 5 to 20 to 60 minutes a day. But with work and all, you know, it's tough to do that. All right, next exercise. Weight's gonna be back on this foot here. Your hands are gonna be like this, and your toes are gonna be pointing up. On this one here, the weight's back here on the back leg. You can actually pick these toes up like nothing. There's no weight there. Everything's holding back here. Switch to the other side. All right, and the last pose is the horse stance. So your legs are slightly wider than shoulder width, knees slightly bent, hands at the middle dantian. Alright, that's it for the posing. Now, hands are here. You're going to step out. Hands are going to go up over your head. And you're going to come down this side of your body. Just reach whatever's comfortable. If you can get to your toes, that's good. And come up the sides of your leg. One hand goes to the front, one hand goes to the back. You step back. The hands meet in front. You step out. One more round on each side. All right. it's time to generate some energy to the palms. Couple more. All right, we're gonna rub those hands together and just put that energy wherever you feel it's necessary. Then you're gonna rub this part of your hands together. It's called large intestine number 4 on the meridian. And you're going to bring that right to your back. Now we're going to do the eye exercises. So you're going to take that energy, rub your hands together, and you're going to put your hands over your eyes with your eyes open. Then you want to look up and down. We'll do 5 times. Up and down 5 times, rub your hands together again, side to side 5 times, and then circles counterclockwise and circle clockwise. So 4 different exercises. Ready? This is a condensed version. If you're doing this at home, you could do up to 36 times for each exercise. All right, last set. All right, now you want to take your fingers like little beaks. You're going to tap all around your skull. Try to hit as many points as you possibly can. Alright, now you're going to massage your ears, again trying to hit as many points on the ears as you can. And then you're going to take an open palm, you're going to try to tap right here on your back, just reach whatever's comfortable, and at least 5 times. You can definitely do more if you want. Then come to the opposite shoulder. Again, just do whatever's comfortable for you. Back and forth along the outside of the arm. And switch to the palm and the inside of the arm. Go to the opposite side. This wakes up the whole nervous system, sending impulses to the brain. one hand behind the head and tap down that side. Switch to the other side. Right here on your hips, open palm, and then you're going to switch to a closed fist. And then you're going to take those fists, put down the outside of one leg, up the inside, do two rounds of that, switch over to the open palms. I like to get the bottom of my foot and the top, my ankle, and switch to the opposite leg, do the closed fists. All right, now you're gonna take whichever leg you want. You're gonna kick it to the front three times. Kick it to the side three times, and to the back three times. And then you're gonna make a large circle going forward, opening up that hip. Again, whatever's comfortable for you. Now you're gonna swing the leg backwards, and you're gonna slap on the outside of your shin bone three times. Switch to the opposite leg. Three kicks to the front, three to the side, three to the back. All right, so now you got all this energy all built up. Now you want to bring that energy down. First exercise, your palms are here. You're gonna go up over your head. And then as you're exhaling, you're gonna reach down to whatever's comfortable. If you can reach the floor, that's great. If not, go to the knees or the waist. We're gonna do this five times. You're picturing all that energy going into the ground. And we're going into a relaxed, meditative state. Last one. These are great exercises to do before you go to bed to calm your mind, bring that energy down, and you can do more than five. We're going to change to the next exercise. The hands are the same, but this time you're going to stop at the lower dantian. Last one. Now the last exercise, we're just going to bring the hands from the lower dantian to the upper dantian. Float that energy down. Last one. Now we're going to shut our eyes and go into a nice meditative state. And we're going to do the lower dantian breathing. Thank you for joining me for Qi Gong with Randy Emerson, and I hope to see you at Veterans Field real soon, Tuesday night, 6 p.m. to 7 p.m.